This morning we read Psalm 109. It's a psalm of absolute despair. You must know what it's like when people who you've tried to help, who you've tried to be friendly to, just speak evil against you. They're always complaining about you. They're moaning about you. They're accusing you. They're stirring up trouble. And here is the position the psalmist found himself in. And look how angry and upset and down he is as he pronounces all those curses on the person or the people who are doing this to him. Folks, understand, your words and your criticisms and your complaints and accusations drag people down. You can read in the words of the psalmist how far he'd been dragged down by the things that he was saying he wanted to happen to the person who was causing him these problems and difficulties. I have to say, I know how he feels, because words are hurtful. You can have 20, 30 people tell you you're doing a good job and thank you for what you're doing. And one person who criticizes, and it's that person whose thoughts stick in your head and who cause the harm and damage. And here is this psalmist, just desperate in this situation, brought so low by it. I don't take seriously the curses he's pronouncing. They're just expressing how he feels. He calls out to the Lord, "Help me for your name's sake. My heart is wounded within me." And sometimes we feel, "My heart is wounded within me. Just help me, Lord. Just help me. Save me according to your unfailing love. While they curse, may you bless. People may complain about me. People may moan about me. People may pronounce curses against me. But Lord, I'm more concerned about what you say about me. What comes from the lips of the Lord concerning me is more important." He says, "I'm going to praise you, Lord. I'm going to praise you because you stand at the right hand of the needy to save their lives from those who would condemn them." In the end, we are the Lord's people. Folks, be careful with your words. Be careful with your criticisms. Make sure if you're going to criticize someone, it's constructive to help build them up and help them be better, not just to complain about them and tear them down. Because the damage that was done to the psalmist by someone's words is the damage you do with your words when you tear people down. Those of us in ministry know it. We see it. We experience it. And we can empathize with this psalmist. Let's use our words to build up. Let's not bring people to the position that this psalmist was in. Amen.